Travis, how'd you become such a great vacuum cleaner salesman?
I'm no different than you are. I've just had a bit more practice, that's all.
Well, I feel bad. I'm 16 years old. I've never sold a vacuum cleaner.
When I was your age, I felt that way too. Back then, I was feeling really guilty. I mean, I've been attending this vacuum cleaner store ever since I was little, every Sunday morning.
Our head salesman at the store didn't make things any easier. Practically every Sunday, he reminded us that we were supposed to be out there selling our vacuums.
The whole world! And sell vacuum cleaners! In fact, vacuum cleaners are a must!
Except for Sunday mornings in the safety of the store, I couldn't even admit to anybody that I owned a vacuum. I'll just be a silent salesman, I told myself. But that didn't work out too well. One day I was sitting with my vacuum cleaner on the bench in front of the school, nervously hoping nobody would notice the machine. Suddenly, Marsha Zembrowski from my English class walked by.
Hi there.
What vacuum? I don't know what you're talking about.
She looks at me like I decided to wear my shoes on my head.
Say, I've been noticing something different about you. You have something the rest of us don't have. What is it anyway?
My socks. I have this match green and pink socks.
No, that's not it. Hey, you've got a vacuum cleaner, don't you?
I've never heard of it. You must have me mixed up with somebody else.
But isn't that a vacuum cleaner?
No, that's my dog. Good dog, good Fido, good boy.
Huh, sure looks like a vacuum cleaner.
Like an idiot, I kept patting the dust bag until Marsha disappeared. Was it a wonder my friends didn't want to buy a vacuum cleaner for me? But I couldn't give up. Not with our head salesman reminding us each week of our responsibility. So I changed my approach. Instead of being meek and timid, I'd pull out all the stops and get aggressive. Really aggressive. To get my courage up, I picked a total stranger on the street corner as
you
my
pig!
Target.
Your floors are filthy! Your carpets are a disgrace! You should be ashamed of yourself! Woe to you who have not vacuum cleaners! Your houses will be engulfed in dirt! You must buy a vacuum and you must buy it now!
At first I thought they'd all been so touched by my speech they'd run home to get their money, but when they didn't return after 3 or 4, 7 hours, I gave up and went home. Then I got an idea. What I need is an instruction book. So I picked up a pamphlet called Vacuum Cleaner Salesmanship at the Store, grabbed my vacuum cleaner and headed across the street.
Yes?
Good day, Mrs. Insert Name here. I'm from the Osseo Vacuum Cleaner Store, and I'd like to tell you the features of our MSV-17 cleaner. The armature is connected to the 17th screw of the plate containing the brush housing under the suction fastener.
What?
Must be in a bad mood, I thought. So I tried the next house.
Good day, Mr. Insert Name here. I'm from the Osseo Vacuum Cleaner Store, and, I'd like to tell you about the features of our MSV-17 cleaner. The armature is connected to the seventh screw of the plate containing the brush housing.
You know what? That sounds really good. I believe I really could use a vacuum cleaner.
Under the suction
But I wasn't going to let my presentation be interrupted again.
The black Bakelite is adjustable at a 45-degree angle and a 2.5 horsepower AC 120 motor with a pre-lubricated bearing served by a spring-activated switch with a...
But when I finally looked up, the door was closed. I couldn't figure out why. Dejected, I went home and switched on the TV. I thought back to last Sunday's meeting at the vacuum cleaner store. Our head salesman told us to...
Get out of your comfort zones, people! Expand your territory, go out into the highways and the byways, and bring those people in!
The next day, I ran into my friend Bob Berkelman in the music room at school. I thought, here goes, Once I get him into the store, he'll be sure
hi,
to
Bob,
buy.
How are you?
Fine.
Say, Bob, I was wondering if you wanted to come down to the vacuum cleaner store with me this weekend.
Vacuum cleaner store? Why would I want to go there?
Well, I can't tell you that.
Why not?
Look, you'll really enjoy yourself. We have a great head salesman, and he gives a great sales talk.
Now, wait a minute. Don't you already have a vacuum?
Well, yes.
Then why don't you try to sell me on it? Doesn't yours work?
Well, it's not that. It's just that, well, I'm not really a professional, and we have people that are trained to do that sort of thing.
No way, man. My mother used to take me to the vacuum cleaning store when I was little. I was bored stiff.
You won't be bored. We're having a movie on vacuum cleaners and special speaker from the company headquarters. I'm a failure. I'm never going to be any good as a salesman. Oh, Chandler must have missed that. Might as well clean it up.
So I plugged in my vacuum cleaner cord into the wall and went to work. I was almost done when I heard a voice.
Excuse me. I couldn't help noticing your vacuum cleaner there. It seems to work really well.
Yeah, I guess it does, as a matter of fact.
Gets it really clean, eh?
That's right.
Where do you suppose I could get one?
I stopped. Speechless. She's asking how she can get a vacuum cleaner. Finally, I stuttered.
I'd be glad to tell you I got mine.
And so I did. That's how I sold my first vacuum cleaner.
It's kind of funny. All that time I was worried about sales methods. But I guess what the company really needs is more demonstration models.